Hello, welcome to FlixWater YouTube channel. Today, I want to share some valuable insights on how to lower alkalinity in your pool without affecting the pH. I understand that this can be a common concern for pool owners, so let's dive right in. Before we discuss the methods to adjust alkalinity and pH, it's important to understand why we should address high alkalinity in the first place. High alkalinity can lead to various issues, including reduced effectiveness of chlorine, physical irritations like red eyes and dry skin, cloudy water, and even damage to pool filters. So, it's crucial to maintain balanced water chemistry. Now, let's address the fact that it's not possible to lower alkalinity without also affecting the pH. These two factors are closely related, and any adjustment in one will eventually impact the other. Alkalinity acts as a buffer for pH, preventing it from dropping too low. To lower pH, we must reduce alkalinity, and that's why pH tends to decrease when alkalinity is lowered. Typically, pool owners use muriatic acid or sodium bisulfate to decrease alkalinity, which consequently lowers the pH. These substances are acids and convert the bicarbonates present in alkalinity to carbonic acid, dissolved CO2, resulting in a decrease in pH. The higher the total alkalinity, the more acid is needed to reduce pH. But what if the alkalinity is high while the pH is not? In such cases, the solution is to lower both the alkalinity and pH first, and then raise the pH back up to normal levels. Here's what you can do. Step 1, lower alkalinity using sodium bisulfate or muriatic acid. This will slightly decrease the pH as well. Step 2. To raise the pH without affecting alkalinity, you can aerate the water or use a small amount of soda ash. Now, let's discuss the methods to reduce alkalinity in your pool. One commonly used method involves the use of muriatic acid, but you can also use sodium bisulfate as an alternative. To lower alkalinity, you'll need the following materials: 1. Liquid drop testing kit / pool testing strips, 2. Appropriate safety gear, mask, gloves, etc. 3. Muriatic acid or sodium bisulfate. Here's a step-by-step guide to lowering alkalinity using muriatic acid. Step 1. Test the pool water, then turn off the pool pump and allow the water to settle. Step 2. Calculate the amount of muriatic acid required based on your pool's volume. Generally, it takes around 25.6 ounces of full-strength muriatic acid to reduce alkalinity by 10 ppm in a 10,000-gallon pool. Step 3. Pour the muriatic acid into the deepest part of your pool and let it sit for an hour. Step 4. Turn on the pool pump and let it run for 5 hours. Step 5. Test the pool water alkalinity and pH levels. Once you have successfully lowered the alkalinity, you may find that the pH is too low. To raise the pH back up to normal levels, you can choose between aeration or using soda ash. Aeration involves exposing more of the water surface to the surrounding air, allowing carbon dioxide to escape and increasing the pH. You can achieve this by pointing your return jets upwards, leaving water features running, splashing around in the water, or using an air compressor with an aeration nozzle. Another option is to use soda ash, also known as sodium carbonate, to increase pH while slightly raising alkalinity. While soda ash is easier and less time-consuming than aeration, it still has a slight impact on alkalinity due to its chemical composition. To prevent high alkalinity in your pool, there are a few tips you can follow. 1. Regularly shock your water to kill algae, as algae consumption of carbon dioxide can cause pH levels to rise. 2. Turn off water features whenever possible to minimize unnecessary aeration. 3. Use low pH chlorine tablets. 4. Avoid using high pH household products like borax or baking soda. 5. When filling your pool, use water with a lower pH. To summarize, while it's not possible to lower alkalinity without affecting pH, there are effective ways to adjust both and maintain a balanced pool environment. By understanding the relationship between alkalinity and pH, using appropriate chemicals and methods, and following preventive measures, you can keep your pool water in optimal condition. Remember, a well-maintained pool leads to enjoyable swimming experiences and avoids potential issues down the line. So, take these insights to heart and make your pool a refreshing oasis for everyone to enjoy. Thanks for watching the video. Please subscribe to our channel for next topics or click to see the next videos on the right.